Good morning, students. Once again, we are back for our English classes. In a previous class, we had studied the first stanza of the poem Darkling Thrush. Before we start the second one, I would like to repeat the first one once again. Here the poet described the intense cold winter season and he was leaning against a wooden gate. It was twilight and the sunlight was fading because it was the end of the day. Frost had covered each and everything there on the earth and the scene was of complete desolation. Now let's come to the second stanza. Here the poet says that the 19th century had come to an end and the sharp features of the land seemed to the poet to be the century's dead body which was ready for its burial. The poet saw the clouds. And these clouds, he thought, would serve as a burial ground for the dead body. The hard wind seemed to be lamenting over the death of the century. The process of conception, pregnancy and birth had slowly slowed down because of the extreme cold of the winter. The extreme cold and frost had robbed every living creature of zest and enthusiasm. It showed that the people were dull and tired. They did not seem to have any life in them. The poet himself does not feel cheerful and enthusiastic in any way. Even he is tired and dull. Thus, from the first two stanzas, we come to know that the poet is still describing the nature only. He seemed to be the lover of nature. He has not come to the title of the poem. But in the third stanza, we will come to know that the poet is confused and puzzled. Why he is confused and puzzled, we will study that in our next English class.